Hi all, subscribe to our channel on YouTube and click on the bell icon to get the latest updates. For course inquiries, visit our website www.gatelectures.com and don't forget to register and subscribe to the latest post section.
Hello everyone. Welcome to the series lecture of Engineering Mathematics. In Engineering Mathematics, the first topic I will discussing is matrices. In matrices, we have learned what is a matrix, what the types of the matrices, the properties of the matrices, the trace, what is the trace of the matrix, the determinant of the matrices, and the operation on matrices, the eigenvalues, and the solving the system of linear equations. First of all, what is a matrix? Actually, matrix is a rectangular arrangement of set of numbers in rows and columns. That means if our matrix denoted as A is nothing but if you collect all the data and write in the way A11, A12, A1n, A21, A22, A2n, similarly AM1, AM2, AMn, where the horizontal is called row and the vertical array is called his column. So, what we have right here, if you have a collection of data and if you put in a matrix, all that data in matrix type, where row wise, this is the m rows here, total number of rows, total rows here in the this example is m and columns is n. So, here this is m by n. Order is written by first it is row then column. This is a representation of order of a matrix. In some book also written in that form and also in AIJ form, if you write a matrix in AIJ, it is nothing but I varies from this are rows, I represent a rows and J represented as column. So, this is the matrix of a row wise and the all the entries are in column wise. Actually, if you go back, firstly, matrix is a Latin word, for womb. That means any places where something is formed or produced, in here in the big rectangular where these all the values are, say it's a entries of all the values. So A11, A12 and so on, AN are the entries of a given matrix A, and also the matrix are represented in the AIJ form in this way. So any place where something is formed or produced is known as a matrix. Actually in later 1850, this theory was only used for solving system of simultaneous equation, But nowadays, matrices are very useful and it is necessary to learn the types of matrices and how the matrices are used in real life problem, such as matrices are one of the best tool in the mathematics, and it is necessary use in various branches of mathematics. It's necessary to learn the matrices. In real life, the matrices are used, it take in physics problem, physicists are used to solve electric circuits in which they are used matrices to calculate the current, and the Kirchhoff's laws also apply. If you recall, then the matrices are used in the physics, also in the computer science, computer application, where matrices are widely used nowadays, such as in animation, matrices are used in 3D games, also in the robotics, also in encryption. Encryption means if you want to send a private message to somewhere or someone, matrices are used for decoding this private message. You encode the message, and here he will or she will decrypt the message, and the matrices are used also in the encryption, means in the cryptography. Also, scientists used matrices. Scientists use also matrices for collecting the data for their experiment. That means, if you are a climatologist, if the collection of data, if they record a temperature at Delhi, at Mumbai, Pune or Kolkata, on each hour or after 6 hours, say first they measure at 5 a.m., then 11 a.m., after 6 hours, say 5 p.m. and 11 p.m. In all the location in the Delhi, Mumbai, Pune, Kolkata, as suppose the Delhi temperature is A1 at A1 degree centigrade, at 11 a.m. A2, A3, A4. Similarly for Mumbai is M1, M2, M3, M4. Say Delhi, so D1, D2, D3, D4. At Pune, P1 temperature, P2 temperature at 11 a.m., P3 temperature at 5 p.m., P4 temperature. At Kolkata, K1, K2, K3, K4. At particular year, if they store a data for year, this will be huge complication, but in matrix, it can be used by only if you take hourly, or in the column, you take the data of 5 a.m., 11 a.m., 5 p.m. and 11 p.m. for one day. It is for one day. Similarly, you can generate another matrix for second day, similarly for 365 days. So in a matrix, it is easier to handle such type of huge data and collect all the data and try to put in a matrix form. Suppose if all the 365 days convert into big A, where now the climatologist analysis which day is warmer than other days. So this is also an example of in real life problem. Also, if you want to tracks of population, in the tracks of population, if the government take the all the data from all the cities and how much population in all the cities in India, suppose. There is also a collection of data in which in the survey analysis the matrices are used. If in the class, in the school, in particular school, matrices are also used widely, also used. If so in the school, can say if in class 10th exam was held, say minor exam was held, and suppose A, B, C, D are the name of the students, I want to here explain how in daily life a matrices is used. And then A, B, C, D are the name of students, and their subjects are suppose maths, physics, chemistry, and say English. And if you know all the marks of A, B, C, D in their exams, and we write either you write row wise of the subjects, suppose maths, physics, chemistry, and English. And here in the column, the marks, if you put the marks of the students, suppose A obtained maths in maths 90, 91, 92, 95. A obtained in physics, say 85, 86. Take any values. So here, this is also an example in the particular classroom. This is the name of the students and this is their marks in particular subject. It can be also written in that form. You can write A, B, C, D in the rows and maths, physics, chemistry, English in the column. So it depends upon what you want to do, and matrices are also particularly used in all the schools, the collection of data. And suppose this is a minor exam. Again, after minor one exam, similarly minor two exam, and then major exam. So if we want, and this is a particular class of only for four students. Now you think, if any school had 1000 students, and in class runs the school from 1 to 12, how many school have a big data? But if the matrices are used in that particular data, the things are going to easy, because in the matrix, if you put all the data in the matrix, the total of sum of the particular students can be easily calculated, and also in particular class, and these matrices can be used by in the given particular exams. So now we are going to deal what are the types of the matrices, and if you want to know the exact types, then something is easily to solve in the matrices.